see if I should be like that. You can see the wagon out front. That wagon, that's my project this week. I'm gonna be planting a couple different types of lettuce. What else? I have quite a few vegetables that I'm gonna do fall planting that I need to get into there this week. Pull out the tomatoes. I do have some onions in there that are already growing and they're probably ready to eat. And some peppers that we've eaten. But my tomatoes were not, I was not happy with my tomato harvest. I got a few cucumbers, nothing to write home about. And we used to have elephant ears planted around the pool. And I'm not going to show you where because I need to do poo duty. But we threw the roots out there into the woods. And now we have elephant ears there and over there. And I think there's one further down there as well. So kind of cool that they didn't get wasted. They still got used. Ooh, I need to zoom out. But today has been about Dexter, taking care of him, letting him relax and heal. Come on, babies. I need to call my husband back because that's who was calling, and I need to water these mums. So I will hopefully will pick up the camera each day this week. Maybe I can do a few days of a vlog, try to keep up, see if there's anything else I have forgotten to talk about because it's been a long time since I vlogged. I told you about the black eye. You guys already knew about that. Did give myself, these are the red aspen nails. I do need lotion on my hands, but I love these little plaids. I don't know if you can see that. I did, they're called autumn plaid and black tie affair. So this side has the two in the middle and the three blacks. And this side I did opposite. So I thought they were fun. It was a very busy work weekend and it's a very busy work week. And Emily is moving. So next Saturday I have to work, but Sunday we're going to help them finish moving and hopefully she'll do a tour of her new home and everything. It's so awesome. All right, I'll check in with you guys a little later. All right, so I figured I'd sit out here a little bit. It's really nice. It's probably 75-ish out here and you're wobbling on my leg right now. Sorry. That was my husband. We own a couple of rental properties in the area. And back in March, let me take these off. You're going to see my black eye. Back in March, the area south of us had a pretty wicked F4 tornado come through. Massive amounts of damage to people's houses. I mean, it literally skipped my daughter and my son and hit areas in between their houses. And I just don't understand how it didn't hit their houses. I'm so thankful. But my God, the amount of damage was unreal. These people were homeless. There were no houses available for rent. The hotel rooms were all booked up. I mean, it was horrible. Well, we thought at our rental properties that we didn't really have any damage, but my husband had to go put up a piece of siding that had fallen off. And next thing we know, we have water damage in the ceilings of the garage and then two of the rooms. This is just at one of the rental properties that we own. And so we got a guy out there and he said it was from the tornado. Thankfully, it was from the tornado, but it is quite a bit of repair work. And we're going to have to re-roof the house, which is fine because you can't, they no longer make the shingle. The house was built in 2006, I think. And I guess they don't make that shingle anymore. So we're battling back and forth with the insurance company who wants to pay to have the shingles repaired, but they don't make the shingles. So they need to replace the entire roof. So the guy that works for the roofing company, he's absolutely fabulous. He answers the phone every single time I call him, which is saying something for, I mean, it's really, really nice. I don't have to leave a message or send him a text message. He's very responsive. And he has been the one going and meeting the inspectors out there and he's handling everything. And I really appreciate that. And then a few weeks ago, everything seems to always happen at nighttime. A few weeks ago, we were getting ready to go to bed and I was like, it's kind of warm in here. And Adam went and checked the thermostat in our house on our main level. So we have three levels, three AC units. And we're on our main level. He went and it wasn't even turned on. It said it was no power or something. And of course, this was at like 9:30. I was headed to get in the shower for bed. And of course, 9:30 at night, we were up. Long story short, the pan inside the attic for that unit had overflowed and it wasn't supposed to overflow. There's supposed to be a stop valve or whatever. And I now have ceiling damage in my living room, which we can't fix because it's 18 feet high. So this same guy, we were just talking to him about it. He's going to send somebody out here tomorrow to take a look. And he thinks he can get somebody out here tomorrow to take a look, to have that repaired, because that's not something, I'm not going up 18 feet on a ladder. I'm just not going to do it. And so they need to scrape the ceiling because it did like a seam separation or something. So they've got to scrape it, putty it, and then repaint it. And I want somebody to do that that's not going to destroy the rest of my house and my furniture at all. And years ago, I had the living room and foyer area painted again because I didn't like the way the original painters painted it. They did such a crappy job. Oh my God, I need to have it done again. I paint a million times better than those quote-unquote professionals do. And you can see the roller marks on the walls. But the worst thing was is that they didn't cover everything the way they should. And they splattered. I still to this day occasionally find the gray paint on my hardwood floors. I used to have this Italian leather chair in my living room that's now in my bedroom. And it had paint all over the back of it. I was so pissed. I mean, it was a $2,000 chair with paint down the back of it. Little splatters because they weren't careful. They didn't cover it. So now I'm really, really careful. And I'm very, very clear on what I want, how I want things done. You okay, buddy? There's that Coolaroo bed out here that he's laying on. He's just now realizing that he's got that thing around his arm where they had to do his blood work. Guys, he's so sweet. All my doggies are so sweet. FYI, it was not Dexter, and it was not Indigo, and it was not Jax that I had the collision with. Emily was over here with her dogs 2 Mondays ago, and they went swimming. And Emily's new house has an in-ground pool, and we were talking about the, what do they call the skimmers on the side of the pool and cleaning them out, and I was showing her my drain baskets, and I bent down to grab the one that's closest to the shallow end, and I picked up the lid from the skimmer. I didn't see Aaron, and Aaron didn't see me. He came barreling around the pool as fast as he can, and he's 80-plus pounds, and we had a collision. I almost passed out. I literally felt like I was seeing through a tunnel, and I had like a ringing in my ears. I thought I was going to pass out. All I kept thinking is don't fall in the pool, don't fall in the pool, don't fall in the pool, because I didn't want Emily trying to figure out how to get me out of the pool. So I stumbled over here where I'm sitting now on the chair next to me and grabbed hold of the chair and kind of just bent over, because then I felt very nauseous. And she kept asking me if I was okay, and I was like, I don't think I am. I probably did get a fractured orbital bone here. I still have some swelling up in here. It's not quite as purple. This is a lot of concealer, several different kinds. I even have MAC Painterly around my eye too, on top of the concealer with setting powder, all of that. So when I take my makeup off at night, it still kind of shocks me when I look in the mirror. I only had a headache for about a day and a half, and the nausea went away within about 30 minutes. Hold on a second. Okay, more stuff about the insurance thing. But anyway, it was completely on accident. He didn't see me. I didn't see him. He was playing with Indigo and Cade, and they were all roughhousing, and it just hit me. I'm fine. I did not see a doctor because there's nothing they can do. If I had been, wicked headache for a couple of days or actually thrown up or whatever, then I would have probably made an appointment to go see somebody. But it didn't feel that severe to me. Actually, I was very surprised. If I can remember, I'll put a picture here. I think I might have put it on my Instagram of when it first happened. It was just a little, it was a large lump right here, all up here on my forehead. And it was like in the next day and a half, when everything kind of fell down my eye, I was kind of blown away by my body's response to that. I guess if I'd stood on my head, it would have gone up and this area would have been bruised. I don't know. I'm joking. But I didn't feel like it was something I needed to go be seen for. I did ice. I did arnica. The arnica I felt like was a complete... I did the oral arnica and the arnica around my eye. And I don't feel like it did anything. It has now been 2 solid weeks since it happened. And I'm still... It's not as purple blue anymore. Now it's like a brown, purple, yellow, green color. Which is really hard to cover. Oh my God. I even went and got some Dermablend or something. And it doesn't... I mean... It didn't do any better than any of the other things that I was using. So it'll eventually go away. I just wear, like when I'm working and I'm working with the public, I wear my sunglasses as much as I can. Lots and lots of concealer. I just, you know, I've been home or at work. So if somebody asks me, I mean, what I don't want, you know, is assumptions about what happened. I mean, I've got camera footage. My whole house has cameras all the way around it. I'm sure if we went back, we could actually see the collision. I didn't look. But yeah, just being out in public and you see a woman with a black eye, that just, I don't want anybody to think, because I had the gentlest husband on the face of the planet. It was a collision with a dog. So that's why I was not feeling about showing my face on YouTube or Instagram, other than the picture with an explanation. But you don't walk around in public with a sign above your head saying, I got headbutted by a dog. You know, people just immediately make assumptions. And I don't ever want someone to think that of my husband, my amazing husband. So, oh, we had our 10-year anniversary the Friday after this happened. There is a picture of us on our anniversary at that restaurant, and I strategically had lots of concealer on my face, and I strategically placed my left eye as my forefront eye so that this one, because this one wasn't even all the way open yet. It took 5 days for my eye to open all the way up. It was the first day and a half. It was so swollen, it was hard to drive because I could only really see out of my left eye. And that made me feel like I was nervous. I felt like I wasn't safe to be behind the wheel of a car. So, but yeah, it took several days. And even on the night of our anniversary, the eye wasn't fully open yet. So I just kind of placed, I wanted a picture of us on our 10-year anniversary. I mean, it was a decade. So it turned out okay. There's a funny story now, you know, I'll remember that forever. But we went to this amazing restaurant that we've been to one other time. Very, very pricey, but totally worth it. I mean, they cook nothing from frozen. It's always fresh. That's work. But it is $5.55. Adam can answer that. It rings both of our phones. Adam knows that I've got the camera on. What was I saying? Squirrel. It only takes a ringtone to get me off track, right? I don't remember what I was saying. Oh, restaurant. The food was amazing. They cook nothing from frozen. Everything is fresh made. All of the desserts and whatnot, which I had for, you know, we had, I had the prime filet. My gosh. The prime filet. I had asparagus and I had a salad. And then because it was our anniversary, they brought us out this little piece of cheesecake that was homemade, and I had a couple of bites of that, but it was our anniversary, and that I don't feel like it did anything. I know that I'm not supposed to be eating a lot of sugar, but I was careful about the rest of what I'd eaten that day. And I don't know how many inches I've lost at this point. It's time for me to measure, but I'm down 17 and a half pounds and my eights are very, very comfortable now. So that I could probably, actually I did the other day, put on a pair of sixes and still a little snug, but you know, they went on my body. That was a good thing. Anywho, all right, I'm not going to bug y'all anymore tonight. I'm going to hang up this thing and I'm going to let my doggies do their thing. And I will talk to y'all tomorrow. You hear the gunshots in the background? I live in the woods. Hey guys, happy Tuesday. It is about 2 o'clock in the afternoon. I just finished some work and just finished filming a Stitch Fix. That'll go up probably before this is what I'm going to assume, because I'm going to try to vlog as much as I can this week. We are hanging out at the house. I just brought the dogs out. I'm trying to keep them calm because Dexter can't do a whole lot of running around right now. And that's what he wants to do. That's all he wants to do. So once I get them settled in here, I want to go out to my garden and plant the winter stuff that I bought, or fall winter stuff that I bought for planting. But I need them all to kind of chill. I'm afraid to leave Dexter too long because he, you know, he's walking around right now. But I don't want him and Jax to roughhouse, or him and Indigo. He usually roughhouses with Jax the most. I just want to make sure that nothing gets injured. So I'm afraid to leave them in here for too long. So I'm going to hang out with them for a few minutes, and then I'm going to go work in my garden. I got to pull up some of the stuff in there before I can plant. And it's a little hot. We dropped in temperature last week. We weren't getting above like 72 for a while. And now we're 88 or something like that. So the fall for us is completely, there are no rules. You need to take everything with you. You need closed-toed shoes and socks and sandals and shorts and sweatpants and tank tops and coats. You have no idea what it's going to be. And it could be all of those different things in one day. So anywho, yeah, that's about it for now. I don't really have a lot to share. I don't think. Nope. All right, I'll check in later. Hey guys, it is now Thursday. I know I didn't pick up my camera yesterday at all to vlog. It was a busy work day, and I had to run quite a few errands yesterday as well, and I just didn't pick up my camera to take with me. I'm heading out now. It's around noon. Finished my morning stuff. I do need to run by UPS and return an order that I ordered from Express. Everything in it was too big and I wasn't happy with it. I hate the fact that it charges you $7 for returns. I mean, there is an Express about 45 minutes away, but I don't ever go into that city, so it's not even worth me doing that. So I am headed to have lunch with Emily. We're going to do our Lean and Green for lunch today rather than dinner. We're going to meet at Clean Eats, and they've got great food, great options, and it's all made with healthy, good-for-you foods. So I'm doing that, and then she and I may do a little bit of walking around. She's been kind of overwhelmed with packing and moving and all of that fun drama that goes along with moving. If you've ever moved, you know how much fun it is. Not. I mean, I look at my house going, I'm never going to move because I don't ever want to have to move all of this crap. So I've got way too much stuff in my house to try to pack it all up into. I would definitely have to downsize. But so I'm going to get her out of the house, and then we'll hang out a little bit. And then I think I'm going to go back to her house for a few minutes, help her do a little bit of packing and see her pups for a few. Dexter's doing wonderful. It's been several days now, and I'm not giving him any meds. I am one of those that I prefer to only use medications if it's absolutely necessary. And I obviously the first day or two for the pain meds and all, but he's never even had to put, I put the cone on his head, or the, it's actually a blue pillow collar, one night. I think it was the first night, just for a little while, because he kept going at it. And I didn't want him, there's a motorcycle, my neighbor. I didn't want him to hurt himself, but he seems to have left the spot alone. He's doing wonderful, eating well. He's just such a good dog. All three of them are so good. So, but yeah, that's where we're headed out. Just a return. I'm dropping off at UPS and lunch with Emily. So maybe I'll pick up the camera with her at some point. And if I have time, I'm on my big camera right now. I'm about to have to put it down because I'm about to be on a main road. And I'm not gonna walk around with it. I'd rather do that on my phone. So I may or may not do that, but maybe I'll pick it up at her house and kind of show you where she's at in her packing process. And I know that she's finally, they have a giant safe, and Connor kept thinking he was going to do it himself. I'm like, you're not moving a safe. I mean, it's difficult for professional safe movers. We have a giant one in our basement too. And I remember the guy doing the delivery there was not an easy task, and he did it professionally. So he thankfully has hired a team to come in and do all the heavy stuff and not have to worry about it. Next week this time, they will have been in their house for a couple of days. I'm so excited for them. So excited for them. I'm excited for the chaos of it to be over and for her to start making the new house hers. You know, there's a few things in that house that she wishes were different, and over time she'll be able to do those things. So and she's got a great eye for it. She's so excited about transforming. I wish you guys could have seen the house that they're currently in, what it looked like when they first bought it. I mean, you could barely see the house from the road, from all the trees. There was no grass in the front yard because it was so shaded it wouldn't grow. and there was no backyard. There was only one upper deck that you couldn't get out of, you couldn't get off of, and it was like two stories up. So they literally took a 20-year-old house and made it younger just by cleaning everything up. All the trees in the front yard were taken down. They redid the shutters. They put in sod. They took 40-something trees out of the backyard. They buried a creek. So the creek still runs. It just runs underground rather than through their backyard. And then they sodded that, fenced in the backyard, added another deck and a half, two decks actually, and a bunch of steps to make their backyard perfect. They fenced in the area. The inside, Emily, there wasn't a wall or cabinet that she hadn't touched with paint in some way, shape, or form. Just, I mean, she literally, in the 3 years that they were there, they completely transformed the way that house looked for the better. And she was, they were both getting compliments all over Facebook. They have the neighborhood Facebook group going, oh my God, the house looks so good. And so she's about to do the same thing in her new one. But all right, I'll check in with you guys a little later. Good Friday morning. Yeah, I did not do any filming with Emily yesterday. We ended up going back to her house and getting all of the accounts transferred over to the new address. And I played with her dogs for a little while. And then I came home and Adam got home and we just kind of had a nice evening and I didn't pick up the camera. I'm outside with the pups. Dexter's found a squirrel. Where'd he go, bud? Where'd the squirrel go? Last night, it was dark and something was running through the woods. I think it might have been a coyote. We live with a lot of wood, so there, no telling. Adam says it definitely wasn't a deer. Dexter was really freaked out. Look at him go. You would think that he didn't just have surgery. I'm not letting him roughhouse, but it's been 4 full days now, and he doesn't seem to have any pain whatsoever. What are you doing, Bubby? And then I've got Jackson to go over here checking out. The wildlife comes into the yard, you know, deer, God knows whatever else. So they spend the next morning smelling it all up, don't you? Indigo, what'd you smell? Was there a deer there? What was it? What was it? I do need to water some of my newly planted flowers and... Oh, Dexter, what you saying? It's supposed to start raining on Sunday again, so... Of course, I plant new stuff and then it doesn't rain. So I have to come out here. Come on, let's walk down to the garden. Let's go see what we got down here. Adam is on his way home. He had to go pick up something that I ordered this morning, about a half an hour away. And I'm very thankful that he did it without me. So I was able to get some laundry started and bathrooms cleaned. And my husband's home. Hold on 1 second. Okay, I'm going to walk down to the garden, show you what I've done real quick. Now this garden is outside of my fenced in area, so I do put some lavender and rosemary. Oh my. Are you guys okay? Did you collide? Yeah, are you okay? You're limping. Uh-oh. Dexter is hardcore. He doesn't have any regard to anybody else's space, and he literally just slammed into Indigo, and she's limping now. So I need to take her inside and take a look. She seems okay. She's not whining anymore, but... He doesn't look as heavy as he is. He's about 70 pounds now. And when he slams into you, he knocks the wind out of you. So, and even myself. So I need to go check her out. Anyway, real quick. I think this is called aster here. I have little purple flowers. It's supposed to attract bumblebees. I have two little moms over here that have not bloomed yet. I think they're going to be yellow. And then just lavender and rosemary planted through here because it helps keep the deer out. Back here, I've kind of given up on this. I've really got a few cucumbers. I never got any eggplant. Not happy with what happened back here. Maybe the blackberries being netted in now will keep the deer. Maybe next year I'll get some blackberries since the deer won't be back here eating them. Got no watermelons. Just, this was a complete and epic fail. This is what I planted inside my little enclosed garden. Let's go in here. Peppers, and you've got one here. It's all nice and wet. It all got watered this morning. Dexter, do not get in there. This is going to be shallots and sweet onion, cauliflower, red leaf lettuce, romaine lettuce, sweet peppers, broccoli, more broccoli. Dexter, no sir, get down. Come on. and then onions, and that's some lemon balm there. So hopefully I get to eat out of my garden for the fall. The first time I did lettuce and whatnot in here was unbelievably successful. I have the cutest picture of Sophia, which I'm not allowed to share, of her at about 4 years old hauling up a giant, her arms were just filled with romaine lettuce. You can see my peppers here have a lot of little blooms. I do see a little bit of insect activity. Anyway, we'll see. I still haven't pulled all my cushions and stuff in yet for the fall. It's still really pretty here. It's still getting up to like 85 to 90. I need to put the wraps away because we're definitely done swimming. But yeah. All right, guys. I have no idea how much I've gotten vlogged. I do have to go to work now. It's going to be a very busy day today and tomorrow with work. Today is Friday. I work on Saturdays. And then Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday, I will be helping Emily pack, move, and clean her new house. And yeah, that's what it's going to be. I hope you guys have a very wonderful weekend. I don't know when I'll be able to have time to film, edit this and get it up. But I think there's two videos that I filmed now that I haven't edited or put up yet. But I hope you have a happy day, and I will talk to you later. Bye.